In this video, we're discussing the two ways to get your Kyocera device registered with Kyocera Fleet Services, or KFS. KFS is an automated toner and other supplies fulfillment software, and it's also an automated billing software. Hey there, I'm Marissa with AIS, and today I'm demonstrating two different ways to register a machine with KFS. Our first demonstration will be through the copier's web interface, and the second will be through the touchscreen interface of the copier. If you run into any issues whatsoever, please feel free to reach out to AIS, and we'd be more than happy to assist you. Registering using web interface. The first thing needed is the IP address of the Kyocera device you wish to register. If you don't know the IP address of your copier, please make sure to watch our video, How to Find the IP Address on Your Kyocera TASKalfa MFP. Next, copy and paste the device's IP address into the address bar of a web browser. If you receive a certificate error, click on Show Advanced, and then click Proceed to Your IP Address. Once you input the IP address of the machine, you'll be directed to the Command Center, RX. Log in as administrative user. Here, you'll enter the username and password for the Kyocera device. Once you are logged in as an administrator, you're going to go to the Management Settings, and then you will go to Remote Services. Remote Services will be off by default. Turn it on and then click Submit. Then, go to Server Settings and select Settings. Here, there are two primary fields that you'll need to fill out. The first is the URL. The URL is https://rfs-us.kyocera.biz. Next, enter your access code provided to you by the technical support rep that you have been working with. This access code is an 8-digit code of random alphanumeric characters, and it's usually just easier to copy and paste that into the access code field. Once you've done so, click Submit. You will know that your device is registered if the Server Settings button is grayed out. At this point, feel free to reach back out to the technical support representative you've been working with at AIS and let them know that your device is ready to be managed by Kyocera Fleet Services. Registering using the touchscreen interface of the copier. In our second demonstration, we're discussing how to register a device from the touchscreen panel of the Kyocera copier. From the touchscreen interface of your copier, access the system menu. Select Function Settings and scroll down to Remote Services. Once you hit this button, it'll request a username and password. Once you are logged in, enable Remote Services and the Server Settings will appear. Now we need to enter two bits of information, the URL and the access code. The URL is https://rfs-us.kyocera.biz. Next, enter the 8-digit access code that was provided to you by the technical service rep. This needs to be entered exactly as it was given to you because it is case sensitive. Once you enter the last character, the keyboard should gray out, indicating that you have entered a full code. Select Enter, and at the top, select Register. It may take a few minutes or two to process, but eventually it will say that it has been completed and registered to your group name. Then you'll select OK. At this point, you will see that the Remote Services and Server Settings options are both grayed out. Please reach out to your technical service rep at AIS and let them know that your device is now ready to be managed by Kyocera Fleet Services. If you still have questions about registering your Kyocera devices, make sure to reach out to us by calling 855-448-4247. We hope you found this tech tip helpful. And remember, you can worry less with AIS.